Bible? Yeah, because you're going to read from the Old Testament, isn't you?
New Testament. I'm going to New Testament.
Yeah, what?
Can I have the Bible?
27.
Just give him the Bible.
Let me show you something. Let me show you something.
Like what?
Let me show it to people.
Like what?
I want to teach the people.
I'll show you.
Let me see.
No.
Anyway, doesn't make. Ami, wallahi, please, let me deal with him. Let me deal with this chicken. Look, he said, Jesus said, love your enemies. But in Luke, everyone who has internet, go put Luke 14:26. Jesus said, hate your mother, hate your father, hate your brother, hate your sister. How in the earth you love your enemies but you hate your mother? Does it make any sense? If you think I'm taking it out of context, go check the whole context by yourself. Clearly Jesus said, you cannot be my disciple.
Hate your father.
Hate your mother.
Hate yourself.
Hate yourself. But love your enemies. But love your enemies. Hate your mother. But love your enemies. Jesus was joking or something. I don't believe that Jesus anyway. But anyway, wallahi, alhamdulillah for Islam. Anyway, alhamdulillah for Islam. But my point here is that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, what the Christians doesn't tell you, that when you study his biography alayhi salatu wasalam, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, 13 years in Mecca, was getting tortured by his people. Oh. You will never hear a Christian saying that.
And Jesus,
you see what I'm saying?
They crucified Jesus and he took off the world.
I don't believe that. Anyway.
What is happening now?
Okay, he was tortured. He was tortured by Salem, yet he was patient with his people for 13 years.
They killed Jesus. Then, Christianity is life religion.
Oh, Jesus is God. How did they kill him?
He's God. How they killed him? He's God. How they killed him? God came to die.
He came to you.
So God came to kill.
He came to die for you?
For me?
Yes.
God.
Yes,
but God's,
in human nature.
God's ever living. God's ever living.
In this human nature.
Is God ever living?
The word became flesh.
I ask you that, is God ever living?
The word became flesh.
I ask you that, is God ever living?
He's also the Father in heaven.
Wallah, you are a marid, Shui Anta. Hada marid, hada. Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah, Allah saved him from his sickness.
You will be saved.
Wallah, wallah. Anyway, I think you know there's no point.
Anyway.
The question again.
Anyway, he's not answering.
It's Mary.
Suffer. Anyway, my point here is, Ikhwa, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam for 13 years in Mecca, calling people to Islam, being patient. Ammar, his family was killed. Naam, many people were killed. Prophet sallam, yet he did not even fight against them. He left them. He left Mecca for them. He migrated to Medina. Yet the pagan Arabs were after him, tried to kill him. Logic dictated, any country in our time, if you have enemies coming to your country to kill you, what do you do?
Yeah.
You fight back. Do you know what? What else has to do with it? Anyway,
one who leads the religion.
Excuse me.
What about that?
No, wait. Wallahi, ikhwa, wait. No, ikhwa, wallahi. I'm going to deal with this victim. Is it wrong?
Islam.
Is it wrong? Give me the Bible. In the Bible, if someone prostrate, you should kill him first. Is that Jesus?
Is that love?
Okay, does God change his mind?
No, gospel fails.
So why God says kill here, but it's not kill?
The gospel.
Let me change his mind.
The gospel.
Anyway, I think you should leave Christianity.
The gospel.
Because you're enslaved by the Christianity.